Ni hao, and welcome to Rauta's reviews. Today I have good news for everybody. Yeah, this is the first Chinese band ever to come to Rauta's channel, and I guess might be just very well in all my 16 or something years, the first time I actually reviewed a Chinese band. Given the fact that there have been quite many Japanese bands out there and many releases coming that way, China being the number one populated country in the world is not exactly a metal country. So all the more exotic when we actually get some metal out of China, and this time it's black metal. So let's welcome the band Black Reaper. Now this is actually a CD which I got because some viewer of the channel requested me to do a review of the CD, and then I did what was requested and contacted the label, which is kind of Pest Productions, which then again replied that they would send us CD, and it took a little bit tough time, quite a few weeks in fact. I don't know what's going on with postal offices around the globe, but anyway, it finally arrived in mint condition, so I'm happy to show you this beautiful digipack, which is, by the way, the debut album of this quite new and young band. So, Celestial Descension is the name of the album, and as I told you, it's a digipack, which in my opinion looks really nice. Not only the colors and the packaging itself, but I don't know, there's something that totally, you know, moves me in a way. So underneath the CD, which is just basically the same thing as underneath, as you can see, this is just, you know, kind of a beautiful green color of, I don't think the camera will do total justice. And as you can see, there are no holes or place for a booklet. So this is just like, you know, cardboard booklet, but a CD, digipack, without no booklet, no lyrics, no pictures of the band members, no photos, whatever. Well, the band member lineup here is obviously three men, even though it says on the band website that this is two-man band, but as you can see, this is a Shizun cell list. And by the way, that means a lot on this CD. So here it goes. This album ticks for about 55 minutes or so, and it starts with an intro which I thought to be a violin, to be honest, but it seems it's a cello, and what a beautiful way it is to actually open this release. Now, if any of you have watched Chinese movies, let's say Kung Fu drama, or I don't know, any other drama for that matter, you might get, you know, a kind of a feeling that you've heard it before. Not like exactly the same compositions, but you know, the feeling, at least in my ears and brain, remind me of something. And now I figured out, they are those kind of a modern classic kung fu movies, just as like, you know, Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, and Hero, and the like. So kind of a beautiful stuff, very atmospheric in a way, but then again, kind of something that sets you up for the mood on this album. And before anybody is going to ask, and like, so come on, tell me what this music is all about. Well, it's melodic black metal. Now, this album also ends with an outro that is very similar to the intro here. So yet again, cello playing, kind of atmospheric, kind of a sad tunes in a way. And I think this kind of makes a lot of sense. It starts and ends almost the same way, the outro being maybe a little bit more melancholy than the intro one. There's also a hidden track, which I don't know why it's called hidden in a way. There's 90 seconds of silence, and then starts this very last track, which is not mentioned in the track list, I think. No, it's not. And I don't know why it's hidden in that way or not list, because it doesn't exactly bring any new value on this CD. I think with the outro, maybe could have been a little better. Also, curiously enough, considering that this melodic black metal, there's a Dismember cover song. Yes, the Swedish death metal band, and it's just Life, Another Shape of Sorrow, which is exactly surprisingly well fitting for the atmosphere of the album. First, I didn't actually pay attention to that. When I was reading the track list and, you know, setting up everything for review, I just like, now this kind of sounds very familiar track. And then it like clicks me suddenly, hey, I just read about something like this member on the track list, like later on when I was spinning it, I don't know, the second time. And then it was like, yeah, well, why didn't I know this in the first time? Well, it doesn't matter. But the thing is, this is actually a very good example how a non-genre, I mean, considering the album, the context, a non-genre track actually fits very well. I mean, black metal's band doing a black metal cover kind of makes more sense and it's more easy to, you know, fit in. Say, there's a band like Marduk doing a Bathory cover. Obviously, you can hear the difference, but it's still black metal band playing black metal song. But now when black metal band is doing a death metal cover song, it kind of feels weird and wrong at the same time as it totally fits the album. Now, like I said, music-wise, this is a melodic black metal. And to be honest, it's not that exotic, it's not that weird that you might figure out coming from, I don't know, some province of China. The thing is, this is quite Nordic in its style. And this is as much as a disappointment as it's good news for the listener. Disappointment in the sense of it's not sounding very Chinese, except for maybe the outro and the intro. But the way these guys are playing music on their debut album is actually quite nice. Now, the language of melody, so to speak, that is very good. I mean, the guys exactly know how to, you know, make these songs work. The tempo is quite, you know, high, fast, and, you know, that kind of delivers more kind of aggressiveness that it would be without this kind of a fast tempo blasting, maybe. I mean, the songs being melodic are not exactly aggressive, but this fast tempo kind of rushes them forward in a way that it actually, well, gives a little bit of aggressiveness to the whole, I don't know, well, the whole music, whole composition, the whole atmosphere of this album. Then again, some of those melodies are also quite melancholy in nature. And that is, in, I think, kind of a the forte of this album, because it actually gives this a little bit of that Nordic feeling without being Nordic. And while I'm not totally like supporting like copycat, you know, Swedish black metal or the like, well, can I blame when these guys are actually doing more good than bad? Well, at least way better than, you know, bad. I think it beats mediocre albums left and right. But I mean, kind of originality would have been something that would probably given this album a little bit kind of uplifting thing. What I'm trying to say here, it could have been just even more better if the lineup, the guys behind the band would have been a little more courageous, you know, doing their music. While it's quite nice as it is, it still seems to lack something. It's kind of a typical debut album in a sense that the overall idea, the kind of like basic design is already there, but given the fact that some of those songs are not exactly memorable, to be honest, most of them are not. I mean, the most of the riffs are quite good, and I mean, they're kind of nice and easy to listen to. They are not the type of riffs that, you know, kind of stick to your head. There's a couple of melodies which were, I think, very good. I think at least one of them was on track 5, which was something that, oh man, if only these guys could have managed to do more of those on this album. Now, production wise this is quite, you know, clean and even a little bit plastic in a way. I mean, not totally bad way, but kind of a lacking some soul to it in a way, and kind of a lacking personality. Then again, the vocals, which are reminiscent of me, you know, they remind me of some Nordic band, but I couldn't figure out which one. I was thinking of maybe Emperor, but I'm not sure if it's exactly Islan's voice that this voice reminds me of. Nevertheless, it's quite of a good screamy, shriek type of raspy way of, you know, doing these vocals. So I liked him. So, and they are one of the better things on this album, with along with those better parts of melodies. So overall, I definitely think this is a good opener for this band's career, and I'm eager to hear more Black Reaper, not only because it's exotic being a Chinese band, but also because the band actually has quite nice way of, you know, presenting the melodies. Maybe a little bit change variation with the tempo and, you know, the way they are composing the songs would actually make this album a little better. But, you know, overall, the feeling was nice. Cello intro, outro, something that is not a typical thing to do. And I kind of like the traditional way of creating album. Doesn't matter if it's black metal, death metal, but even more in black metal, when this clear intro, which kind of sets up for the mood, like I said, and then it kind of like finishes the album, giving like no second touch what's there to come later on. I don't give a damn if it's a sample or just an instrumental track, or in this case, I just love it when there's like clear beginning and ending. And that's just my opinion. I know there are a bunch of people who just skip all these tracks, but I think they're doing a good job here, and so I hope more people will find Black Reaper after this review. Definitely deserving its attention, even if not gold standard album, at least in this part of the career. Anyway, thank you for watching the review, and as always, so you have any comments or questions or whatever, just drop on that box below and I'll get back to you. See you soon with more Rauta reviews. Bye bye.